Hello students, welcome back to another session of object oriented programming. In this video we are going to discuss about Java tokens. Well, in Java we have several tokens. So the tokens are smallest element in Java. Okay, the elements can be white space, identifiers, literals, comments, separators, keywords and operators. Let us see one by one. So white space. The white space can be a space, tab or new line. These can be ignored by the compiler. So whenever we make a source code or type the program, there is a space or tab or typing in the next line, all these will be ignored by the compiler. Now let us see the identifier. Identifier can be used for class names, method names and variable or field names. This identifier can have sequence of uppercases, lowercase letters, numbers, underscores and dollar sign. So combination of these we can make an identifier. Java identifier is a case sensitive. For example, uppercase letters with the value is different from the first letter capital, all other small, this value. This value and all capital letter are two different identifiers because it's a case sensitive. Every different letters are going to be considered as separate identifiers. Of course, we will discuss about all identifiers in separate when we are going to discuss about class, method, variable with the identifier names. Literals are the identifiers which is going to hold the value, literal value. It can be a real value or can be a constants that is assigned to any of the primitive data types. So primitive data type means we have byte, integer, short, long, float, double, character and boolean. So these are the primitive data type. In this primitive data type we can assign the value. So string can also be a one which can hold the literal value. So string, but string is a class in Java. Some of the example we have given here for the literals. So literal, for example, this is an integer value. So sorry, byte value, or we can also think it as an integer value because byte is a very small item when we compare with the short and the integer. These three and inclusive of long also. So long. This also an integer value. Long, integer, short, byte are the integer are going to hold the integer value, but it has a limit. Byte is very small and short is little big. Integer is 16 bit and long is 32 bit. So we are allowed to only assign a specific value based on the primitive type. And so here, for example, byte b. B is a variable. Of course, we are going to discuss about the variable later on this next video. For example, short s, we have assigned short value. Integer I, we have assigned an integer value here. This is long value, should be ended with the l. So remember this one. And make the floating point value, we have double as well as float. So we can assign any variable here and we are assigned a floating with the F, and for double we are going to say D. Okay, so there will be a fraction point here. So either we can use a floating or we can use double. And for boolean value we are going to say either true or false. A string value can hold with a double quote, can have anything. So string, but string is not a primitive data type, but this is a class in Java. Character can hold any single character only in the character type. So these are about literals. And one more thing about the constant. When we assign primitive data type with variable equals to value, that value is assigned to the variable. And if you are going to say final in front of the data type or primitive data type, that will be considered as a constant. So the constant value cannot be changed once we assigned. So final byte b, we are going to say, for example, the value cannot be changed after a while in the code. But if you are going to declare without final, that is a normal variable, the value can be able to change. We will discuss about this one later in the session, I mean in the next video. Now we go to the comments. Comments can be give remarks that is going to be entered by the developer. All these comments will be ignored by the compiler. So any comments you are going to give in the code, all will be ignored by the compiler. So the comments can help the developer to understand what specific choice I've made and what is written there. So some information about the code, so which makes developer to understand the code for reading purpose we are going to have. That might indicate the code versioning, for example, any information that explains or helps the developer to maintain the code. So we are going to state some information over there using the comments. So the comments can be written in three different forms. Can be a single line comment by using slash slash, double slash, or we can use multi-line input as like C++, or we can use documentation purpose comments. So three different comments are there in Java. When you come to have separators, we have different separators which can be a parenthesis, can be used in the end of the method, braces for opening any closing classes methods, brackets can be used for any array declarations, and every statement will be ended with a semicolon, comma for separating the arguments or the parameters, dot for bringing any object values. So different separators are there, so this can be used in the program code. When you come to see about the keyword, totally 52 keywords are there in Java. So these keywords we should not use it in our program when we are writing any identifier or the variable, method name or class name in our program. We should not use this keyword because these are all reserved keywords. We have to observe this one. So have a glance of look into all the reserved keywords, and those keywords should not be used in the identifiers for variable or method or any classes. Remember this one. And finally, this is an operator. So operators are going to perform operations. So operator will perform operation with one or two or three operands. So the operands are the objects, can be a field variable or objects, okay? And operators are symbol represented to do the actions. So when you make any operation, we need operands and as well as operators. For example, we used to say a equals x plus 4. Assume that a is an integer value and x is also integer value, and we are making plus operation with the 4. So based on the x value, the operation is going to be changed. So what we can say is here plus is the operator and x is operand, and then this value will be stored in the a variable here. And one thing, the operation may or may return the value. So may or may not return the value, meaning if we are going to say 5 plus 4, for example, immediately it will return the value. So because the value is already known, so immediately value is assigned to a variable. If x is given without knowing this x value, we cannot proceed, meaning there is no operation performed here without knowing this one. So this is why they say operator may or may not return the results. So it is based on the equation that we formed here. Okay, this is all about Java tokens, and we will be separately discussing about the operator in the next video. Thank you very much for watching this video.